What is the minimum number of attacks needed to beat Dark Souls? There have been a lot of videos from a lot of incredible creators to tackle all sorts of challenges, from the one-shot challenge to pacifist runs to beating the game with exclusively firebombs. But despite watching as many as I have, I could never find a video going over the exact minimum number of attacks it takes to beat the game. Let's change that, yeah? We'll start by talking about what constitutes an attack by my rules. For the purposes of this run, I'm defining it as any action directly resulting from a keyboard or controller input that's meant to cause direct harm to any creature in the game, or any offensive action taken by an allied entity for the same purpose. This includes the usual suspects, like light and heavy attacks, but also throwing items like a firebomb or a dung pie, kicking a target to knock them off a cliff, purposefully jumping on a target to deal damage on them Goomba Stomp style, or parrying them to get them to fall to their demise. That last line in the definition is particularly important, since it means that we're going to be banning the use of any and all summons. I want this to be as close to a true pacifist run as possible, and if your concept of nonviolence is just to place the weight of the violence upon others to keep your hands clean, you're no more a pacifist than a mob boss is. With that said, let's get down to business. Let's work our way backwards. To beat the game, we first need to beat Angry Flaming Grandpa, which means at least one hit, a fully enhanced cast of Chaos Storm to be precise. To beat him, you need to beat all four Lord Souls Shard Bearers and stuff their souls in the Lord Vessel, gained from old Snorlax and Pikachu. The worst boss ever only takes about one hit. I don't count jumping on the side thingies as an attack, since, at least to me, it feels the same way as rolling through these boxes to access the Undead Merchant. That puts us at two. Then there's the Rave Lord, going down with a single cast of Chaos Storm, and Mr. Raisin a Family, another one-shot, taking us to four. Not a Scaly Seath complicates things, since we need one to beat him, I used Firestorm here, but we also need one to get out of the cell he locks us in after killing us the first time we meet him, so that means we're now actually at six. And the Four Kings, well, you can kill them in just one hit, but it requires the Fire Surge Pyromancy, which is found in the Painted World and is dropped by an enemy that you have to kill. The Wheel Skeletons do not friendly fire, I checked. I lack the technical skill to pull off the maneuver, but here's some footage from Titus Actual's Soul Level 1 one-shot challenge video of him doing exactly that. Link to the full video below. As far as I know, you can't actually one-shot the Four Kings using other methods, like a single cast of Tranquil Walk of Death force cast with Dark Moon Blade, due to the time it takes for the kings to spawn. Tranquil wears off before enough kings spawn to kill in one hit. So we'll increment our counter to 8. Then we're also going to add up to 9 for Sif, since we do need the Covenant of Artorias to get in there in the first place. That handles the Lord Souls, but then there's Biggie and Smalls themselves. Damage can't be carried over between phases, so you need to kill both a normal and a super. Ornstein goes down like a chump, and Super Smile follows him to the grave. Getting into An Orlando requires we take out the Iron Golem, making it 12 hits with a solid cast of Chaos Storm, while getting to him requires we take down the Bell Gargoyles and Quel'lag. Bella and Goyle here require that we deal enough damage to one before the second one spawns in, making it difficult to kill them both in one hit. While Fire Surge would work, we can't access that Pyromancy without access to An Orlando, which they gate off, so we'll have to increment our counter to 14 with a couple great Chaos Fireballs. To get the second bell and unlock the path to the Rhymes with Witch of Izalith, though, we'll need to take out a Lava Hot Lulzsworn here and her brother. Ceaseless can be beaten by jumping onto his hands just right, which I couldn't do, so here's more footage from Titus Actual's one-shot challenge video. I'm counting that jump as an attack, by the way, making the total 15 before dealing with Quel'lag. Quel'lag is probably the second hardest target to one-shot out of every boss in the game under this rule set, at least for me. I had to get a +4 enchanted Demon's Great Axe, since it's the strongest weapon you can get without attacking. A +15 could technically be possible, but it requires you get the Very Large Ember, which requires you attack Ingward for the key, at least at this stage. So with 50 intelligence, power within, red Searstone range, and +3 Dragon Covenant with the Torso Stone, and a plunging attack, I was still just barely missing the threshold for the one shot. Because on top of that, you also have to land the plunging attack so it hits her human body up top, and then you'll just barely manage to kill her in one shot to raise the total attack count to 16 thus far. Major props to Titus Actual again, since I never knew you could plunging attack in that arena until watching his video. Interestingly, getting my axe to enchanted +4 is one of the only two things in this run I came up with on my own without watching someone else's video first. Then we have to add a 17th attack for the Capra Demon, since we need to get the Pyromancy Flame from Laurentius. We need power within for most of the game, and the only ways to get it are either from him, from Engi after Quelag, or from starting the game as the Pyromancer, which we're actually about to get into. Now, there's only one enemy technically remaining, the Asylum Demon. You can't level up at this point, so we have to figure out how to maximize our damage based solely on our starting class. Our main options here are either to start as the Pyromancer, the Thief, or the Bandit. The Bandit can kill the boss in just 3 hits, while the Thief can kill the boss in 5 hits using black firebombs. The Pyromancer, meanwhile, can land the kill in 6 hits, while also removing the Capra hit for a net gain of 5 attacks. We'll be moving forward as the Bandit, incrementing our counter one last time by 3 to a total of 20. Thus, we can directly confirm that we can beat all of Dark Souls Remastered in just 20 attacks. Delightfully round number, isn't it? But a bit too high, if you ask me. And Dark Souls is a game with a huge number of glitches and skips, so there has to be a way to get the number lower, right? So let's do exactly that. Let's start with the beginning. The Asylum Demon takes 3 hits to kill the Bandit, as there's no way that I know of, at least, to kill him in fewer attacks than that. But the goal here isn't necessarily to kill him. A fun little fact about Dark Souls Remastered is that there are some pretty fun interactions between running at 60 frames per second and certain scripted animations like grabs, or certain plunging attacks. If you're playing as the Cleric, you can perform a plunging attack on the Asylum Demon and get upwarped out of bounds, letting you carefully roll your way down past the gate, having only attacked once. That drops our counter down to 18. Our next glitch is going to be to get rid of that pesky attack on the Capra Demon. By climbing up the ladder on Remastered, looking to the left and doing some funny steppies, we'll walk out of bounds and we can advance until we fall down in the waterway that leads to the Moss Lady. Next, we'll change our equipment until we're just above 25% equipment load to reach a state referred to as meme rolling, where we can roll infinitely in midair. We roll down into the depths, our meme roll's invincibility frame saving us from the fall damage, before we run forward and turn left at that second-to-last ceiling support. Jumping along it will take us just above Laurentius, but that alone isn't quite enough since we can't save him from here. Instead, run in the direction of the corner he's in and jump over him like this, then walk along the roof towards a tunnel in the distance. Run jump up there, walk around a bit, and then fall into the depths proper through this opening. Go find Laurentius, do not sit at the bonfire since it'll soft lock your game, and then homeward bone out. Congrats, you now have the Pyromancy Flame without attacking the Capra Demon, saving you one attack and taking us down to 17. And while we're at it, let's go deal with Quelag and Ceaseless, shall we? Ceaseless is easy. I don't have footage of it because I'm not as good of a gamer, but here's Yumfa performing the Ceaseless skip in his video, which you should go watch if you haven't, because I only came up with 2 strategies in this entire video, and this ain't one of them. As for Quelag, well, if you're not familiar with Quelag skip, then you're in for a bit of a treat, because I have not one but 2 different methods to show you. I would have used just one, but I forgot to record before resuming on my first attempt and lost a chunk of it. Whoops. We do this by exploiting the death cam caused by either A, doing this sequence of rolls and jumps into a plunging attack into a well-timed roll to mitigate all fall damage, which I spent literal hours attempting, only to get one successful attempt that didn't properly record, or B, stepping on some broken pots. It's really that easy. Thank you to TKGP for the technically faster Quelag skip that made me want to throw my PC out the window, but is better for speedrunners. And thanks to Yimfa for easier path with the pots that's better suited for a casual like me. Considering it was in the pacifist video of all things, I'm stunned I never remembered it until then. Either way, since we've already walked through Quelag's boss fog once before, we can just walk through the unloaded battlefield and quit out. We can ring the bell here. We would need to do this a second time later when we come back to beat the Bed of Chaos, but don't worry about it. With that, we can remove 2 attacks, one for Quelag and one for Discharge. Our counter is down to 16 now, and we no longer need that plus 4 Enchanted Demon's Great Axe with 50 Intelligence and Strength, but keep that int at 69 instead. Not for the joke, but for the subtle foreshadowing. We can't do anything about Iron Golem, sadly, but Ornstein Smell? I hope you're ready for the trick so damn bad, I nearly quit making this video entirely because, oh my god, I hated this. I know it can be done legitimately, but for the life of me, I just lack the skills to do it. Hours and hours of gameplay, constantly dying later, and here's the footage of it finally working. This right here is the only reason I could never see a thriving speedrun community for at least a tax category. This golden bastard has to be standing in the corner as he performs his grab attack, and then you have to weave into him just right, and still get hit, and then you'll phase into the ceiling and see all Van Orlando for a moment, and then he'll clip through the wall and fall to his death. I hate you, Ornstein. I hate you so, so much. You can lower the counter down to 14 by experiencing this hellish form of self-flagellation. After that, we have the skip for pretty much the rest of the game, honestly. Once we've rung both bells and have the Lord Vessel, we can just go and perform a well-timed quit out. Since the game is a failsafe in place for when your data gets all funky and weird, if you quit out while the game is trying to determine where you respawn while you're attuned to the Lord Vessel Bonfire, the game just spawns you in the kiln. That means we can remove one for the Bed of Chaos, one for Sif, one for the Four Kings, another for the Fire Surgeon Ariamis, one for Pinwheel and Nito, and we can drop both Seath and the annoying little guard too, without even having to use Duke's skip. I still did the skip anyway though, so here's footage of that using the setup I got from QQ, cause I adore that skip, and it made a miserable trick so much more reliable. Link in the description. And next, we've got a bit of a surprise in that we're going to be revisiting the Asylum Demon. See, I was rendering the first version of this video, everything else was done and dusted and ready for final reviews, when I got distracted by getting recommended a bow-only speedrun from Mino. I clicked in and watched it only to find out that she used a technique that I didn't know about to just casually skip the Asylum Demon entirely, saving one more attack. Not only that, but it also opens up our starting class so that we can start as the Pyromancer instead of the Cleric, giving us the Pyromancer's Flame without having to save Laurentius. Genuinely incredible. Her full video is linked below. With only a handful of skips and glitches, we've lowered the overall number of attacks to beat Dark Souls to just 5, the lowest it could possibly go. Getting it any lower would either require a new skip that lets us bypass one of the bosses I've mentioned, or the ability to kill both gargoyles in a single hit that doesn't require Fire Surge. That is where the record stands today. Or at least, where it stood yesterday. See, I had originally written off the Tranquil Walk of Death glitch for the Bell Gargoyles. Not because I thought it was impossible, but because I couldn't think of a way to set it up properly, since I didn't know if it could spawn the area. But then, something happened. I woke up in the middle of the night and realized I'd forgotten something pretty simple, something really basic. When you step through the boss fog for the Bell Gargoyles, you drop. There is a neck-high ledge in the Bell Gargoyles arena. The moment I realized this, I knew there had to be a way to set up spell swap for this, and I realized that the only option was a glitch I kind of knew from back when I played Prepare to Die Edition. I was used to using the tumble buff, where you kind of take advantage of the action queuing system in order to be able to do things like moveset swap, or allow you to apply crystal magic weapon to something like the Stone Greatsword. But I knew, thanks to the Purple Coward Crystal glitch, that you could also apply things like resin to an item that normally couldn't, like Super Smile's Hammer. That also meant that if you drop down, you should be able to apply something like, say, Magic Weapon onto the Stone Greatsword. Then the special Tranquil Walk of Peace attack when you're two-handed the Greatsword would start dealing damage in the area around it. Without access to Anor Londo, it became clear that the only buff spell and catalyst I had access to would be Magic Weapon with the Sorcerer's Catalyst, and I wasn't even sure if it would be strong enough, even with my 69 in intelligence. But I kept grinding it out and thinking about it, even going online to look up if others had done it, where I came across a video by Ray Dimitri showing him doing it with the Darkmoon Blade buff. Clearly, it could be done with better equipment than what I had, but could it be done with the equipment I had at my disposal? There was only one way to find out. And there we have it. Both gargoyles killed in one move. Dark Souls can be beaten in not 20, not 15, not even 10, but 4 attacks total from the start of the game to the end. And unless someone else is able to figure out a strategy that skips one of these bosses entirely, then that's where the record will stay for a long, long time. Thanks for watching.